sa imong mga general realizations from going through all that, like about life? Did it change your perspective? Did it, was there a shift in your mindset, your outlook?
It's hard kay ako mangod, I after high school I went straight to Manila, and then after Manila I went to Beijing, I studied Mandarin. I went to China for 2.5 years. I also went to Canada for 2 years. So my whole perspective in life really changed from then on. Like, you know, I know what I want. So I grew as a person. I grew up pretty quick.
Murag ni broaden imong perspective sa katong sige kag biyahe. I remember nag-abot man ta for a time katong imong stint sa BM, di ba? For a while you worked with us katong
waiting for my kuan sa Canada, I had nothing to do. So murag traveling made me realize a lot of things. So it also in a way helped me now with how I cope up with the loss of my mom also, because I've lived in different countries. I talk to her every day, almost every day. So the thought,
so close jud mo sa imong mom.
Yeah, so kids. So in terms of her presence, I'm used to it. Yeah, I'm not with her. Okay, I'm always abroad.
Yeah.
So
ni broad din sa to no, yung respect, meeting different cultures, different people, different races.
And like when I was in Beijing, my friends are from Germany, Australia, Nicaragua. So I got an idea as to how their cultures are. So muna na realize na kung morning Filipino time na to, na late kita kay ang akong friend from
on time
from Spain
jod, lahi, no?
From Spain ako na friend, late sige sila, kung 1 hour late sila, two hours, three hours late sila.
Relax po day.
So muna sa lang, like akong friend from Germany, that's the reason why kanang German innovation is very kanang top notch, because they will never settle for
German
less.
Cars, diba?
Yes,
no, diba? Naman dyan reputation na kanang perfection.
It's their mindset. So my friend, if I'm a minute late, suko sa siya. So I got to see how
you learn to adjust to different mga cultures and
So muna nakana ko, okay. So akong idea gid as to how life is, lahi na gid siya. After, I think sa Beijing, I've grown more as a person there.
So you went to Beijing, Canada, US. Primarily for studies or work experience?
Beijing, studies gito.
Mandarin?
Yeah.
Maka-Mandarin pa karon? Or
wala
nalimtan?
Wala.
Taya na. Taya.
Pilago na nato. Dapat ay Bisaya, dapat ay Manila, Tagalog, dapat ay English.
So China, Beijing was to learn Mandarin. Yeah, Canada.
Canada was really more for experience in the business side of things. Kay,
you worked for a company there?
Yeah.
Murakag intern? I mean, you really...
I worked there. I actually helped a lot of families there.
Unsa na na industry? Which company was that?
I worked as a... I process people's permanent residencies. So, kanang all... Kita, we're the number one. Actually, we're for a couple of years we've been the top country that moved to Canada, aside from China.
Okay, asa sa Canada?
Alberta.
Alberta.
So, sa una namon tay bubble sa US na nurses. So when that bubble burst, dito na sa nibalhin ang mga tao sa Canada. Okay, kailangan mas lag kanang mga
I hear great things about Canada.
Yeah, it's very
kanang
nice.
Limpyo niya, presko daw kayong pagkaon.
Yeah, everything is really kanang organic.
Yeah. So, pagay ko kaad to.
nindot. So, kanang dito, grabe kita o mga workers yun dito. So, that's what I did. I processed their permanent residency. Kanang para ma-immigrant kid sila. So, katong na-experience was actually very humbling also. Okay. I got to see how hard it is to be away from your family. Like, ilang gingon sa na kanang American dream, na nindot kayo na when you move there, you know, it's very nice. Mm. But in reality, well, also in America, I got to see that. Okay, I studied there for a bit. But
where
in, Canada,
in America? So it was Beijing, Canada, then
San
America.
Francisco, yeah. So in Canada, like these families would be away from their you know, these people would be away from their families, and they all live in one house, they rent per room. So you know, they don't get to see their kids, their wives here back home. And then when they apply for their permanent residency, mura mo siya kanang green card pa sa States. So sa Canada, permanent residency PR na. So when they apply for their permanent residency para ma-immigrate na sila dito, yeah, you get to see their whole life from ilang college, kay imo mo gunay declare tanan where you went to, when where you went to school, yeah, yeah, how many siblings do you have, your family, your kids.
And so, how long was that for you, that stint in Canada?
2 years po.
2 years po.
Yeah, so, kana...
Did you come home for Christmas? May ano?
Not really. Just meet up with my family somewhere. Sa gawas ba? Like,
so, daghan sa kagkabuang nagian? Like, mga,
daghan sa...
Mga drunk stories or women or...
wala bang kayo. Okay,
those days ba? I mean, bachelor days, single days.
Actually, kato, wag mong kukoy, di man kay ko, kuan good. Usually, I'm long term mo lang ako mga uyab. I never really got to enjoy, pero I enjoyed my,
yeah, I think know. You strike me as someone like family oriented man sa
yeah, di mo
kukoy. Ka nang, yeah, nakay ka ng limits that you don't cross, but
yeah.
So, in a way, there's some structure also in how you live.
Matuo mo ko kung karma gid ba? It may not come in my time, but it might come sa akong kids ba or unsa ba? So, marag, you reap what you sow also. So,
marag, yeah, marag ko an tuyok ram kalibutan.
Cycle ram ko sa iba. So, di sa kiko mo pa kuan, but Canada ka to, my work there was very humbling. Kay you get to see their...
Dako sang sweldo, my son. How's the pay?
Actually, di man. My pay there is...
It's more on ang experience, no? Kana you can't... Di mo na mabayaran ang kanang actual experience living
dako
through
siya
that.
Dako siya dali. That's why murag...
But ang standard of living, taas po. So, murag yeah, mauma-ora.
Wala gina, maingon sila nga. Their tito, their titas are working there. Hatago ka ng... mga mahalo na mga shoes, mga na, pero murag dito, murag dako, nagikina, good.
Yeah.
Muna siya sa katong mga akong ipang help ba? I think I helped mga, if I'm not mistaken, I think I helped 800 families. Ako silang i-reunite, good, dito. So, listod na ha, kay, ang government man good, they don't tell you when that program will close. So, some have been there mga 6 years, 8 years, under kanang temporary status lang, working lang sila. So they can never bring their families there. So resort to siya na time put for them. And then wala humbling kita kasi lang bank accounts. Like they need see day by day git sila. Kaya naman ko natanan, i-process sa ako sa nila sa ilang permanent residency, you get to see everything. So humbling git siya nga makaingon kag gabi ano, they're working very hard. They don't get to see their families. They see their families maybe once a year. Kaya ilam na itingob ang ilahang leave. They get to stay here for 2 weeks, 1 month, and then next thing you know, pagbalik nila, nabuntis lang ang asawa. Kay dugay mas na makita.
Nabuntis o lain?
Nabuntisan nila ilang asawa dere. So, like, ipanganak silang anak, they don't even get to see their kids. So, even their kids, dili nila maila-ila. The kid don't even know their father.
Ang abis ko na ilain.
Uba na, asad ba eh?
Nasa ilain, nakamabdos.
Okay. Grabe, ligi kayo kay you're just there by yourself. O man kay family.
Lagi usay loneliness creeps in. So usay mo manifest itself yun na kung alone, like the mind wanders.
Especially if you're in Canada, nga bugnaw ka dito, kay mabuhat.
Nadyo kay mamit, temptation, di dyan malikay.
Sa work ni mo, di good.